What's up, everyone? We're back, but not with another tutorial in Cubase Elements 8 because I've upgraded to Cubase Pro. There were several factors that determined my decision to do this, but the most deciding factor was if you take a look at this track count right here, this template's running 129 tracks. So I'll go through after working with Pro for a couple weeks, the main differences I see from Elements, tell you about them, and then wrap it up. So Pro, the main difference is track count. So with this orchestral template, I wanted to be able to. Load a different articulation for each track so that I can compose quickly. And Pro makes that possible. There's not enough MIDI tracks to be able to do that in Elements. So that's the main reason I upgraded. Another reason, another thing that I'll use in Pro that's not available in Elements is side chaining. So let's say we want to put a compressor on the cellos. Compressor. But we want the compressor to receive input from the timpanis. We just push this button right here, activate side chain. And then we go to our timpanis and we do ascend into the cello compressor. So now this signal from this timpani will work on this compressor to slam down and compress the cellos. So side chaining is a important part of mixing. It's not completely essential, but it is nice to have as an option, and it is an option in Pro and not in Elements. The third reason I upgraded or advantage of Pro over Elements is let's take a look at instrument tracks. You get more included instruments. With Elements, I think you get Groove Agent, Halion, and Prolog. With Pro, you get Loop Mash, Mystic, Pad Shop, Retrolog, and Spectre. I can't say I've used Loop Mash, Mystic, or Spectre, but Pad Shop and Retrolog are both sweet. Retrolog is like an old school synth. And Pad Shop has gorgeous sounding pads, and it's basically like a granular synthesis engine. So, more instruments is always good, and Cubase Pro comes with more instruments than Cubase Elements. The final thing that I'll demonstrate that is available in Cubase Pro but not in Elements are MIDI inserts. So, you can put in inserts on your MIDI, like this arpeggiator, and get stuff like that from within Cubase and not having to write it in. So that's nice to have. So those are the four main advantages that I've seen in my 2 weeks of working with Pro over Elements: the increased track count, the ability to sidechain plugins, more instruments, and using MIDI inserts. Now, I'm sure there's a bunch more, but those are the ones that I've found most useful. But with that being said, Cubase Elements is not a bad program at all. Over the last year, I've done over 100 productions with Elements, and I think they sound just fine. And if you were to go back 20 years and try to acquire all of the features of Cubase Elements 8, it would cost you over $100,000. So it is an amazing piece of software. It's just there is a more amazing piece of software out there, and that's Cubase Pro. And if you're serious about this music thing, you're going to be spending a lot of time in your sequencer. And so that's how I felt, and I felt I should have the ballerest edition of the sequencer that I use, in the Cubase Steinberg product family, which is Cubase Pro. And that's why I upgraded. But Cubase Elements is fantastic. Pro seems to be fantastic so far for me. And if you're interested in acquiring either of these DAWs, you can click the link in the description and I'll get a kickback. I'm not saying that Cubase is the greatest DAW on earth, it's just the one that's pissed me off the least so far, and that is why I use it. So I hope you found this video helpful and the differences between Pro and Elements are a little bit more understandable by watching it. I hope you all have a great day. Bye.